What is it like living at the South Pole? Do you have any idea about the place located atop a 2 mile deep glacier? What would life be like in the coldest, driest, and highest ice desert on Earth? Of course, it would be challenging. One of the first men to walk on the moon, Buzz Aldrin, had to be evacuated from the South Pole as the US National Science Foundation, that runs the US Amundsen-Scott South Pole Research Station, couldn't risk his life. The ailing 86-year-old history-making Apollo 11 astronaut was transported back on a military flight to McMurdo Station on the coast. Later, he was sent to Christchurch in New Zealand. Wondering why this is relevant? Well, he survived on the moon, but couldn't in the South Pole. This place is even more difficult than the moon. Hi, welcome back to the Wealth Lab, and thanks for checking in. The South Pole is the driest place on the planet. It's a location of extreme weather conditions. The winters are harsh and incredibly hard on the human body. There is a miles-thick ice sheet at the South Pole, and it sits at an altitude of almost 10,000 feet. In reality, it feels over 12,000 feet because of the low air pressure and the arid polar atmosphere. During the summers, temperatures are usually a balmy negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit, and in winters, they can plummet to around negative 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Now combine this freezing cold weather with the driest air on Earth, and imagine how it will be like to live in such a place. Even the otherwise insignificant everyday life activities, like climbing a flight of stairs, will become difficult for you if you find yourself in the South Pole during the winter season. The air is so cold and harsh that it causes pain to any exposed part of your body, almost instantly. You may not even be able to smile because doing so, your teeth and gums will start to ache. Smiling can become a painful experience. Just take our word for it. Oh! And how can we forget the dreadful frostbite that can set in far more quickly than the blink of an eye? But that's not all. The troubles are just getting started. On top of that is the minimal light throughout the winters. Believe it or not, the South Pole is pitch dark during the winter. Days become gloomy, and an already limited population gets even scarcer. On the station, the crew has to bring a duffel bag full of cold weather gear such as air-insulated boots and similar stuff just to bear with the extreme weather. Enjoying the video? Remember to hit that like and subscribe button. Thanks! The South Pole is a vast, snowy desert, and there's no native life in around 1,000 miles from the coast. You won't even find a mosquito. So, the first thing you need to prepare yourself for before coming to the South Pole is isolation. The only wildlife in this place are the few humans inhabiting it. There are nearly 66 scientific bases in Antarctica, and about 37 of them stay occupied year-round, while the remaining ones open during the summer and are closed during the winters. Through the summer, there are around 4,000 individuals living in the snowy desert, and during the winter, this number reduces to 1,000. Mostly, people prefer to stay on the South Pole during the summers only, which lasts around 3 to 6 months. A smaller number of people want to stay over the winters because traveling in or out is virtually impossible. But despite the dangers, the South Pole has fascinated tourists and explorers for years. Tourism saw an unprecedented spike between 2011 and 2012, when the centennial anniversaries of the Scott and Amundsen expeditions were underway. At the time, hundreds of people made a trip to the South Pole, but let's not forget that this trip is not going to be cheap. On average, an air ticket to the South Pole will cost over $40,000. On the other hand, a 2 month ski expedition would cost you about $65,000. Another setback that you may have to face right after arriving at the pole is that there are literally no extravagant facilities for travelers or tourists. And the research station, where there are some facilities, never houses tourists. That's because the provisions of high-end facilities in a snowy, deserted area is next to impossible. To get there, you have to reach the coast and then ski in or fly in a private helicopter. Only a small fraction of the 30,000 individuals visiting Antarctica per year will visit the southernmost spot on the planet. Now, let's talk about how you'll survive in the South Pole once you make it to the world's biggest freezer. Some things you have to keep in mind and follow throughout the time you're staying in the South Pole. The first and most important tip is that you should keep yourself covered from top to toe and even to the top of your nose. You have no idea how the South Pole wind can flash freeze that part that remains exposed. And it does, instantly. You won't get any time to react, so it's best to stay covered. Another important point is to stay hydrated. The air out there is really dry. It's so dry that your body will lose water as it breathes. You'll need at least 8 liters of water daily just to stay hydrated. And as far as meals are concerned, your body will require some extra calories just to stay warm. The best way to ensure this is by eating fatty foods. We've even met people who ate as many as 8 chocolate bars in a single day. Now, you can opt for other tactics to stay warm, such as doing sit-ups, jumping jacks, or just swinging your arms around to get the blood flowing back into your hands and toes. Also, you'll have to beware of the umbels, or as the Antarcticans refer to, a person who starts to stumble or mumble. Watch out if anyone develops a white patch of frozen skin on their face. The stumbling and frozen patch are signs of hypothermia. If it happens to you, remember to increase your fluid intake and stay warm. In the South Pole and the entirety of Antarctica, winters are so cold that the ocean surface gets frozen, resulting in sea ice. Although it is an important place of work for the researchers, but it could be highly dangerous for visitors, as there's always the danger of falling through a crack. Or you could be standing on a piece of ice that isn't solid enough and just floats away after breaking off. If you want to determine ice thickness, use an ice auger. It's a drill-like device mainly used to cut through the ice or dig deep holes. But you can use this to gauge ice thickness. If its thickness is less than 60 centimeters, it won't be safe for you. Always watch out for signs of seals, such as their feces or tracks, because the presence of seals means there will be snow-covered cracks. You can test for cracks by poking your ice axe into the snow. Enjoying the video? Remember to hit that like and subscribe button. Thanks! You should also keep track of the weather while you're in the South Pole, though in Antarctica, the winds are sustained at over 100 miles per hour. To give you an idea of how strong this is, that's strong enough to blow away an entire vehicle, and the weather here changes quickly. A clear sunny day can become dark and dangerous within minutes, so we suggest that you always keep yourself prepared for the worst. Watch the weather. If you hear or see a storm blowing in, stay indoors. If you're outdoors, get to a shelter as soon as possible. If you want to stay in a camp, it is better to prepare it for heavy winds. Use giant stakes to rig the tent and orient them in a way that they won't be blown away. Another important thing to keep in mind is to never go anywhere in the South Pole without a shovel. It could be a lifesaver in case you get stuck in the snow. Before visiting the South Pole, get trained for whiteout conditions and practice exercises like putting a bucket over your head. As you move closer to the pole, the longitudes will come closer and converge at the pole itself, so you may ski to the left or right for just 1 kilometer and find yourself in a completely different time zone. Solar navigation also becomes really tricky in this region for skiers, especially in the whiteout. Whiteout in the South Pole is an incomparable experience. It can strike at least once in 3 days. Since the ice is flat and there's nothing but the sun and your own shadow to navigate through, skiing may become difficult. All you'll be left with when a whiteout occurs is a white, empty space. You have to learn to navigate in such conditions beforehand. The most disorienting part of living at the pole is that here, the sun neither rises nor sets. A full day will be the time between 2 sunrises, while the South Pole's full day can last approximately 8,760 hours. That's because, at the pole, the sun rises once a year and sets many months later. During summers, you'll get 24 hours of sunlight, and in winters, you'll get 24 hours of darkness. This lack of sunlight may cause vitamin D deficiency in you, which is why you should stay at a place where there is a sunroom, and if not, at least have access to vitamin D lamps. Enjoying the video? Remember to hit that like and subscribe button. Thanks! Living in the South Pole may not be as difficult if you are fully prepared and accept it for its shortcomings. Wouldn't it be a worthwhile experience seeing more stars in the sky, moon above the horizon for as long as 2 weeks, and enjoying gradually darkening twilight? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and press that bell icon to keep watching informative content.